Hey everyone! So, today we will do a little different kind of a video. I have won a poker tournament and made six figures in winnings. In this video, I will tell you exactly what I will do with the money, what investment I think are the best, and what returns I expect. As you might know when you watch about my past, you know that I did play poker semi-professionally and it helped me to make a good living in the past. If you want to watch more about my past, I have a link up here, which is the first part of the video, and I will also link it down in the description. The second part will be linked up here as well and in the description below. As you can see here, I won a big tournament on Saturday at the Deep Stack series of the Venetian Hotel, which I can only recommend to all poker fans who like to play a well-structured poker tournament. But first of all, welcome to High School Dropouts Advice. If you need subtitles, click on the subtitle button right here. If you want to join my Discord channel, you can do this through Patreon, which I link down below in the description. First of all, this is not a bragging video. Instead, this video should reveal the mindset, how you should invest money and how you should look at money. Because no matter who you are, there are moments in your life where you will be able to accumulate some unexpected cash. It can be from stocks earnings, crypto bull runs, inherit some wealth, winning a jackpot, getting some stimulus, grants, or tax benefits. There are countless occasions in your life, no matter how big or small they are, you can use those opportunities to build your wealth. Let me first reveal how much I made. So, as you can see from the post of the Venetian Poker Room, that I made $112,481. It was a tournament with over 1,500 participants. The first day was a 14 hours grind and the second day another 17 hours grind. So it was a long and exhausting tournament, but of course it was worth the hassle. What made me happy about this outcome is that my cousin was paying 20% of the buy-in for the tournament, which was $600, and his stack was $120 for owning 20%. I would have played the tournament either way. I can afford $600 for a tournament, but having my cousin's trust and being able to make a profit for both of us makes me happy. Because if you have money for yourself, will never make you happy. It's lonely to be on the mountaintop. This does not mean I will give my money to strangers, because my philosophy is that you have to invest in me, my ideas, or anything else. And when we get rewarded, we will split. We split the pain, the losses, the patience, the work, and of course, at last, the reward. Now that you know that my cousin gets 20%, which will be about 22,500. I will have about 90,000 left. Let us have some words about the amount first and talk a little about the philosophy of money in general before we talk about how I invest the 90,000. 90,000 might be a lot for some, but might also be very little to some. It really depends on how we will spend the money. Let me tell you, when you can make 90,000, then this is good. If you can keep the 90,000, then this is better. But if you can grow the 90,000 into millions, then this is the best. So no matter how small the amount is, have a bigger aim for that small amount of money. I know so many people who got lucky at some point in their life, and they use that money to spend on vacation, nice cars, luxury handbags, clothes, and other liabilities. Those people will not use that money to change their life fundamentally, but use that money for short-term pleasure. Let me tell you, that kind of person usually doesn't make it far financially, because their focus is on the short term. For those are people who will cash out their little earnings too early on the stock market. They are impatient, start to buy stocks when they are in trend, which means they buy for too expensive. They trade and secure little earnings and justify their decisions by making some profit that it was a good trade. In poker, there are a lot of those players as well. When you are at the final table, the pay jumps get huge. The 9th place gets 16,000, 8th place get 20,000, 7th place get 26,000, and 6th place get 34,000. And the price jumps continues getting larger. So many players are focused on reaching the next pay jump because they focus on the next several thousand, but they lose sight of the six-figure payout for the first prize. You need to think long-term, not just in poker, but also in investment, money management, and in life in general. You need to have a long-term game plan, persistence, consistency, and be a hard worker, and it will pay out one day. Don't let a dollar amount affect your plan. Don't get emotional when you make or lose money. Don't take money personally. Just try to focus on your best game. The results will follow. When others focus on the pay jump, I focus on building the best strategy to abuse my opponents to win the game. It also applies to investment. Take it as a game and have the patience to let it do its thing. There are many things we cannot control. Like in a poker game, I cannot control what cards the other person or I get. I can only play along and let it do what it does. The same is with investment. So all investments, I keep them forever and let the company do what it has to do for at least 10 years to get the most out of it. Don't try to control, make, or hunt or chase for money. Just become excellent and great in what you do, and money will follow. Money is attracted to the ones who run ahead of them. Now, let me tell you what I will do with the 90,000. As I mentioned, it will not be spent on liabilities, luxury goods, or pleasure. My aim is to make money grow and build generational wealth with it. You might think 90,000 is not enough to build generational wealth. I will tell you, generation is equal to a lot of time. A generation is counted in 40-50 years, and wealth is equal to time multiplied by the amount of money is working for you. So we know that time is a big factor for general wealth. As you know me, I will not save the money in a savings account for 1% interest. Instead, we will put the money to work. We could simply put the 90,000 into the SP 500, and we can expect that we will get a historical return of 11%. Let us see what it will make us in 20 years when I plan to retire and start using the passive income as retirement. Let me pull up this investment calculator. You see that we will make $71,907 in interest every year after year 20. This means you can take out $71,907 each year for the rest of your retirement life. And if inflation hits, don't worry, the stock will adjust to the inflation rate. So nearly $72,000 per year as retirement with an original winning of $90,000 is not bad. The only downside for many is that it stays untouched for 20 years. Many of the viewers and people I know don't have this patience. And let me tell you, this is a boring way of investing, even for me. Even when it works out quite well. I prefer this way if I have to choose between a nice luxury car for 90,000 or lock up the 90,000 for 20 years with an interest rate of 11%. Now, let me tell you what I think will happen. I'm not just an eHang investor. I know many people follow my channel because of eHang, but I'm actually more bullish on another investment. which I think will be huge. It's Ethereum. I give EHang a good chance to make 50x my money within 10 years, but I give Ethereum a good chance to make me 100, 230 times my money within 10 years, or in other words, in the next 3 bull runs. If history is repeating itself, we will have Ethereum plunging back to an amount of about $240 to $300, but we know it will come back to about 3 times its previous all-time high, which will put it at around 12,000. Then it will plunge again, then rise again. So I think blockchain will be a major shift in wealth in the future. So I'm preparing myself for this wealth change. I'm sure that many other promising coins will make more than 100x my money, but I feel comfortable with Ethereum. The problem we have is that Ethereum is not at $300 now. I think we still need to wait 1 to 1.5 years for it to hit the bottom. But I will keep about 30,000 aside, which will be used to buy into Ethereum. And if I'm right about 100% X return in 10 years, I will end up with 3 million in additional money just by a $30,000 investment for 10 years. So now let us talk about what I will do with the remaining 60,000. I will use about 50,000 for a 10% down payment on a non-QM loan for a property. This means I will use this money to buy an about $500,000 home. The idea is that I can get out of my current property and rent it out, which will generate about $1,800 in rent each month, which will offset the mortgage. So the mortgage will cost me around $2,150 per month, but at this point I'm looking to generate wealth, and owning 2 properties will definitely generate more appreciation if the market stays hot like now and inflation continues to push the prices higher. I expect an average appreciation of 7% for the next 10 years. So let us see what it will generate us in appreciation for the 2 properties. My current home is worth 330,000, and as you know, I will buy my next property for around $500,000. So the total value of the properties is about 830,000. If we put this in the calculator, we will get this 1.6 million. So we double our controlled property value in 10 years with an initial investment of just 50,000. This means we will make over 800,000 with an initial investment of just 50,000. But we of course still need to pay property tax, insurance, and each month I have to come up with $400 for the difference in mortgage and rent. But I will increase the rent by $75 each year so that it will be easier for me as time passes. And let us not forget what all those tax benefits of owning properties will save us. Overall, as you know, I'm a big fan of real estate investment. When you watch my real estate videos on my channel, I own 6 rental single family houses, and more are on the way at the end of this year. So you know that real estate is a wealth generator when you know the basics of how to invest in real estate. What will I do with the remaining 10,000? The 10,000 I will split half for my parents for anything they want, and the remaining 5,000 will be used for rainy days. So overall, you see that the 90,000 will be invested all, and it will be put to work. I know that there are many ways to leverage the money harder. I could also buy 2 or 3 additional single family rentals on a mortgage and generate more wealth and passive income. But I'm approaching my mid-30s and I need to prepare to have a bigger home and settle down. A 3-bedroom house where we have 2 offices and a studio will be too small to start a family. So sometimes, even as you know the best way to make the most money, sometimes you have to cut back on your ambition and make the most balanced decision so all your pillars will grow evenly. Understand that your life is built on pillars like health, finance, mental condition, and spiritual condition. If you neglect one, it will all break down. So once again, I got lucky in that tournament, but looking back that I play poker for the last 16 years and having a big score once in a while is definitely rewarding, but also feels deserved because there's a lot of work, knowledge, and patience to build this mindset. My last words for this video are that always keep focusing on becoming the best version of yourself, no matter what you do. Don't focus on money. Don't try to chase it, and it will one day chase you. Luck and unluck is a thin line, and everything is temporary. So having and not having is not a big difference. But once you have it, remember to keep it, share it, and grow it. Every person is able to accumulate a large sum of money, but how you spend it, keep it, and grow it will make the difference. Anyways, I'm just a guy on YouTube. Please remember to do your own due diligence and hire a financial advisor if necessary. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel when you don't want to miss out any stock information and investment opportunity. Thank you so much, and see you hopefully in the next video. Thank you, bye.